Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky in the laboratory. As you can see, we've got the whole shebang primered. Different color primers. We're gonna do some different stuff here with some colors coming up. So predominantly though, other than the interior and the engine, everything is in different, you know, black, very dark, ruddy brown, a little bit of rust, and that's just primer stuff. So next up is the paint. We're gonna work on the paint, probably in this time around, one part at a time. You know, these are gonna be very difficult. There goes all the stuff. These are gonna require a little bit of finessing. We have to mask of this so that we can paint it different colors. You know, it's stowage, so we need to give it variety, just for the sake of being able to draw the eye to the bed and to all of the elements. So we have to do that, but I'm liking the way it's looking already. I'm going to lighten up certain areas and spray different colors on here. You've seen this process many times before. We usually have a blast working on these. So we're gonna paint, and then we're gonna do a variety of different shades of rust. Then we're gonna do our salt and hairspray techniques, and then the painting will continue. And you'll see it coming to life the way you've seen it before. We just hope it turns out pretty good. The body, as I said, it's going to be, I'm working off of a picture, which I cannot show you because I have yet to receive permission from the photographer. His name is John Bauman, and he's got a killer picture of a 1950 Ford that I fell in love with, and that's how I'm going to paint this sucker. So he's got black, and then the top of it and a little bit of the bed is all orange. I'm going to do the interior kind of a light olive and tan, and then it's just working out a whole bunch of details. That's basically it. So but I wanted to show you this step because I believe it's a very important step before we continue on to the paint. I always like to primer my models because it buys me a little bit of extra insurance. And regardless of what primer you use, you will see time and again that most builders, you know, use primer. You saw Scott from Scale Model Addict using a different kind of a primer on his, and he made a comment about having, that was what he had available. So you shouldn't really slow down your pace once you get going on a build, and I had to wait on it because of my compressor was out of the house. I had loaned it up, but we're back in business. And so use the tools that you have and that you're familiar with, and enjoy your build. I mean, that's what it's all about. The last thing you want is to end up getting frustrated because you don't have this or that. And it's just a bummer when that happens. So utilize what you have, and more often than not, that'll work, you know. But anyway, let me know what you think. And painting is coming up next, so the fun is about to begin. This is very long, drawn out, you know, painting process, but it sure does have many rewards. And it's basically the reason why so many of us build. You know, you take your build from your mind to what's in your imagination to a 3D model. It's always a terrific, you know, experience. And I mean, a wonderful experience. I didn't mean to say terrific and the horror. I guess it could be a horror every once in a while. But for the most part, it's a very pleasant, pleasurable, joyful experience. So enjoy it and keep, you know, stay tuned in. Keep checking out the Cranky Show. There's more headed your way, my friends. Alrighty, we'll be back.